Monday Reflection for June 11, 2018. I'm Jermaine Gibson. Prayer with Faith. The Doctrinal Text, Matthew 21, 22. Whatever you ask for in prayer with faith, you will receive. A cursory reading of this text is likely to lead us to misunderstand and misinterpret the real intent of Jesus. Interestingly, Matthew 21, 21 to 22 is the principal verse used to support the so-called Word of Faith movement. This is one of the most prevalent movements in modern religious culture, where people assume that they can accomplish miracles by simply having enough faith and speak into being what they want to happen. The assumption is that Christians today are able to command physical things like mountains or trees or even tumors, sources of pain or cancer in the name of Jesus. Hear Jesus in Matthew 21, 21 to 22. Truly I tell you, if you have faith and do not doubt, not only will you do what has been done to the fig tree, but even if you say to this mountain, be lifted up and thrown into the sea, it will be done. Whatever you ask for in prayer with faith, you will receive. This verse sounds like a blank check for Christians. Whatever we want, if we just believe strongly enough, we can accomplish by just speaking a word. Some prosperity gospel preachers use this text too. I agree with Dennis Bratcher, who says, and I quote, "This is a classic example of failing to understand a biblical text in its own context. That failure to hear the text on its own terms leads to projecting our own human agenda onto Scripture and calling it the truth of God." End of quote. Matthew 21 begins what is known in Christian tradition as Passion Week. Among the things Jesus did was to curse a fig tree because it had leaves but no fruit. This is a type of tree that sets fruit before leaves, so the presence of leaves should be a sign that the tree was producing fruit. This is in fact a parable of judgment against Israel. While the Jewish religious system looked good from the outside and by all appearances was healthy, yet it produced no fruit. The disciples were shocked that the fig tree had withered so quickly. It is to this reaction that Jesus responds in the text for today. Here, faith is not some magical power that human beings can exercise on their own. Faith is linked with in prayer, so that faith must be submitted to God in prayer. Clearly, it is ultimately God and His will that govern the things of life. Additionally, Jesus is challenging the disciples and us regarding our role as God's people in the world as servants of the kingdom. The availability of God's power is not for our own self-interests, so we can utilize it to do what we want. No, it is to seek God's power to fulfill God's purposes for the glory of God. When we seek the presence of God in prayer and place our faith in God, we can do the impossible while being God's people and producing the fruit of the kingdom. Till next week, let's seek God anew in prayer, mingled with faith, and watch what He's able to accomplish through us.
Let faith arise. Let faith arise. I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge.